If we haven't found a cause for infertility, we really can't treat something specifically. Therefore, our treatment goal is simply to accelerate the time to pregnancy, that is, get the couple pregnant as quickly as possible. So there are two main principles we utilize to achieve that goal. One is we increase the number of eggs, and that makes sense because humans on their own make one egg a month. If we give fertility medicines that increase the number of eggs made in that month, it increases the chances for conception in that month. The second thing that we do is we actually want to get the sperm and egg closer together. And by doing that, it actually it gives you higher rates above timed intercourse or regular intercourse because we try to get millions of moving sperm into the uterus or upper female reproductive tract by use of intrauterine insemination. Or we can actually go so far as to stimulate the ovaries, take the eggs out of the ovaries, and then fertilize the eggs in the lab, let them grow into embryos, and then put the embryos back into the uterus, which is called in vitro fertilization. So those are our two methods of getting the sperm and egg closer together. Most studies have shown that use of either of the principles, say doing fertility medicines alone for unexplained infertility or doing intrauterine insemination alone for unexplained infertility, do not significantly increase pregnancy rates above baseline. So that's usually not going to help increase their chances for conception in that month. There are two factors that the couples consider when determining which treatment option they wish to choose. One is cost, the other is success rates. IVF has the highest success rates of all treatments. Of course, it has the highest cost as well. But if you actually factor in doing multiple treatment cycles of a treatment that gives you a lower success rate, it ends up being more cost-effective to move more quickly to in vitro fertilization. And more recent studies have actually confirmed that. We would not recommend more than 3 cycles of any given treatment. In other words, most patients who are going to be pregnant with a given treatment have done so within 3 treatment cycles. Usually, in actual practice, most patients do 1 or 2 cycles of a lesser treatment before moving directly to in vitro fertilization.